Hello, makers. For one of my next projects, I need a gyroscope. And I found two versions. The GY6 one, it's this little fella. And the bigger brother, GY291. The little smaller ones works directly. You can read the X, Y, Z values directly from analog inputs. And this one you connect through I2C. So before I make two separate views of each sensor, let's try to combine both and see which one works best. Of course, we need an Arduino and Arduino Nano, because it's very breadboard friendly. And replaces both sensors. So, what have both in common? Of course, ground. Everything needs ground. We connect it to a ground wire. And ground is here on the left, and here on the right. What do we need next? VCC. I checked and both can handle 5 volts. So we're using another ground rail. And 5 volts from the Arduino. I hope the Arduino can power both. So, now to the rest. We will connect to this one first, because this one needs I2C. And the I2C pins on the Arduino are predefined. It's analog 4 and analog 5. Those pins we cannot use for the GY61 sensor. The clock line is analog 5 SCL, and the data line SDA is analog 4. So on this sensor we have three more outputs to wire up: X, Y, and Z. And let's just using analog 0 to 2 or analog 1 to 3. It's more obvious. Ooh, this looks nasty. Well, the main difference between those sensors is how much codes they need to operate. Luckily for the GY291, there's of course a library, and of course an Adafruit library. But you will find it under the name ADXL345. It's a chip that's mounted on the sensor. And you can see here's the marking. I'm not sure if you can reread it. Yeah. So, there's quite a lot of going on here. And I don't think we need to go through this. But I think we should see the results. Yeah, it really seems to work. Easy and quite accurate. And the advantage, you really get real sensor values. So let's see what this little brother will put out. The GY61 is pretty easy. You can see the whole code fits on one screen. You define where you connect the three outputs. In the setup, you define those pins as an input, although there isn't really a need to define an analog pin as an input because it's default set as an input. And in the loop, you read the sensor values and do whatever you want with it. So, uploading it. And as you can see, this sensor also does a magic trick. So, if you now ask which sensor you should use in your project, well, if you want to build your own quadcopter, you should definitely go for the ADXL345. Or aka GY291, because it has an I2C bus, and if you want to build a quadcopter, you definitely want to minimize the pins you use. But for smaller projects, and if you don't have much RAM left, for example, if you want to combine it with those DigiSpark 80 Tinies, this one has three analog inputs, so it would fit the need. It would fit the recommendation to read the sensor values. And you don't have to implement any libraries, any fancy code. You just have to read the sensor values and handle it. Although the sensor values of the smaller brother don't really say anything. The libraries for the bigger one works pretty well, and you really get sensor values that you can use for positioning quadcopter or any other project. I guess for my needs, I could really use those 80 Tinies. And I will try if I can work with this one, because the code is quite easy and I really don't need those exact values this sensor will give me. So I hope you liked this video. Maybe you learned something from it. Thumbs up, share, subscribe. The project I will build with it will go as smooth as working with the sensors. So be creative. Bye.